What's up, YouTube? My name is James, and welcome to Skinny White Boy Reactions. Decided to go ahead and start doing some musical reactions, and who else better to start with than Eminem or Slim Shady? As I've been asking around, people want me to do that, so that's what I'm gonna do. To be honest with you, I did my first video yesterday. I could tell I was getting sick. I'm actually sick today, but I said F it. I'm not gonna just lay around and do nothing, so I might as well actually just work on this and try to make a new video and see what's up. So, I saw that in Time Magazine they named Eminem's Till I Collapse the number one workout song ever. Not just of the century or the last 10 years, ever. So I'm kind of going to go at this video with the with that angle of it being the best workout song ever. Obviously, I probably will forget that in about 5 minutes, but I'm going to try to keep it on point, see if I can do it, and hopefully you guys like it. Again, I'm new to this, so please critique the shit out of me, and I'll try to break down the bars as best as I can. So without further ado, or with it, let's go. By the way, I've heard this song before, so it's not actually a real reaction, it's more of a review. It's been probably 10 years since I've heard it. I looked at the streaming numbers on it for all the people, how they figured out why it's the number one of the century. And apparently people listen to this song all the time. I'm not one of them, so let's see what's up. Trying to remember if I actually remember the song. Sometimes you just feel tired. Yep, as soon as that comes in, I immediately remember it. Feel weak. When you feel weak, you feel like you want to just give up. But you gotta search within you. You gotta find that inner strength and just pull that shit out of you. So with him talking right there, straight up 100, motivational, absolutely. Does it include just working out? No, it comes to anything. Hell, it can apply to me today being sick and just saying I'm going to get up and do this. So yeah, absolutely can see so far why it's a good workout song or for motivation, etc. Till I collapse, I'm spilling these raps. Long as you feel me, till the day that I drop, you'll never say that I'm not killing them. So immediately he comes out, he's gonna be killing the raps. Whenever he's not killing the raps, he's gonna stop. So till the day that he drops, or the day that he's not Eminem, then you're gonna be here in fire. Cause when I am not, then I'ma stop killing them. And I am not popping, I'm just not Eminem. Subliminal thoughts when I'ma stop sending them. Subliminal thoughts, when am I going to stop sending them? Most likely never, because it's Eminem and he does double, triple, quadruple entendres, metaphors, stuff people never understand. That's why half of the stuff goes over people's heads and they can't figure out what the hell he's talking about. Subliminal thoughts, when I stop sending them, never. So right there, he's talking about women and how they're caught in his web. And then he throws in venom as well, because he's throwing out the venomous lyrics towards women all the time. Amoxicillin's not going to make a stop. Basically, all types of wordplay on his anti-women lyrics. At least that's the way I see it. Tell me in the comments if I'm wrong. The criminal cop killing hip-hop, selling a minimal swap. Got millions of block listeners. You're coming. Hold on, so Did he say the criminal cop killing something about the stealing of Pac listeners? Is he talking about Ja Rule? Let me know. So that was dope right there. He said, you hear it a lot, lyrics, something about an America. Is it a miracle or is it he just a product of pop fizzing up? He loves his metaphors about pop or soda. And it's also talking about, is it becoming pop? And is it just fizzing up to the top? Is that why everyone likes it now? So is it actually dope lyrics or is he just pop? Whew. I definitely did not hear this whenever I listened to this like 15 years ago or however long ago it was. Slim Shady does not give a fuck. And now we're gonna have Nate Dogg. Has there ever been a song Nate Dogg was on that you didn't like? Hey. Can't we just bring Nate Dogg back, please? One way or the other? Can we clone him? Something? You remember back in the day when it was like, oh, Nate Dogg's on a track. It's gonna be a fire track. Every single time. Facts. That goes with everything, though. And I said I was gonna do this about the workout thing. So, music is like magic when people are feeling your shit. That goes with anything. Whenever somebody's feeling your stuff, you feel good about yourself. You feel happy. You're excited. So, you're on top of your game in the music game, which is what he is and was at this time. So, it's like magic. You get a high from it when people are feeling it. This is your moment. That line actually reminds me of the people who are like, oh, this band, they sold out, blah, 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 blah. Nah, man, that's the point of being an artist. That's the point of putting your music out. Like, why would you put it out if you didn't want people to hear it? If you didn't want to get everything out of it that you possibly could? If you didn't want to sell out, basically, and get all the money, take it all. Because what? Hold on. What did he say? Get as much shit as you can. So yeah, so get everything that you possibly can while you're in there and while your run is still going. And then when that is in, admit it. And guess what? His isn't over yet. So he's got a list, and here's the order of the list that it's in: Reggie, Jay-Z, Tupac, and Biggie, Andre from Outkast, Jada, Corrupt, and Nas, and then me. So, Redman, Jay-Z, Tupac, and Biggie, Andre from Outkast, Jadakiss, Corrupt, Nas, and then him. So he's putting himself at the end of the list, which is a humble one right there, I would say, for this song. Not sure if Jadakiss is still in that list, because I'm pretty sure he's got a little beef with the Locks and Jada. Not 100% that Jada is Jadakiss. I would assume it is, though, because I don't know any other Jada. But it's a damn good list, I'll tell you that much. But in this industry, I'm the cause of a lot of envy. So when I'm not put on this list, the shit does not offend me. So why isn't he put on the list? And the fact that he's not on the list doesn't make him work double time hard to show how good he actually is, which is why he's so good. And then that goes to what the whole song about, the best workout song ever. Everybody's trying to do double hard. If you actually put the work in and do double time, let's go for your job, let's go for working out, let's go for anything. It's all motivation. I get it. The song, I get it. I get why I was number one. Now I'm getting it. That's why you see me walk around like nothing's bothering me. Even though half your people got a fucking problem with me. You hate it, but you know respect you got to give me. The price is my dream, like bothering you with me. They kick me. So right there, he's talking about already how he's clickbait. But whatever he does, he's gonna be in the press because they know the story's gonna catch fire. So I don't know what this was, 10 years ago, 15 years ago, shit, 20 years ago. But he was already the king of controversy or the king of you put me in the news, you're going to get clickbait. So if it wasn't even clickbait, it was CNN, like news stores, whatever. MTV all over the place. Like, so he's been dealing with this for so long. Even he's talking about till the roof comes off, till the lights go out, can't shut my mouth. But he's it's motivation. Like, I'm gonna keep going until I can't, until they shut me down somehow or I get shut down myself. As soon as the verse starts, I eat it in MC's heart. What is he thinking? About to go against me smart, and it's absurd how people hang on every word. So as soon as the beat starts, I'm going at an MC's heart. Why would he ever go against me? So he's asking for the smoke already. Always. I probably never get the props I feel I ever deserve, but I'll never be served. My spot is forever reserved. If I ever leave Earth, that would be the death of me first, cause in my heart. He said something about people hang on every word, which has always been true. It doesn't matter if you like them or you hate them. People are still listening to him and hanging on every word just to see what he says. Because like growing up, what was it? I was in high school when he came out. And everybody liked him. My white friends, black friends, everybody. Boom, 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 boom. And then his second or third album by that time came around. It's actually funny. My white friends started to think he was corny. And they're like, Eminem, blah, blah, blah. But my black friends were always like, let's see what Eminem's got to say. And still to this day, if he puts something out, I get the phone call. Not from my white friend, it's from my black friend. What's Eminem talking about? Let's hear, what's he talking about? We have our own little listening party. So yeah, people listen to every word. My heart's a little nothing could ever be worse. That's why I'm clever when I put together every verse. My thoughts are sporadic. I act like I'm a addict. I rap like I'm addicted to smack like I'm committed. Slight diss there. Nice though, I know you got it. But I don't wanna go forth and back at constant battles. The fact is I would rather sit back and pop some rappers. So this is like a full-blown attack. I'm launching out on the track. So he's asking for the smoke in this song. All the way back. People think like, oh, Kamikaze or whatever, he was asking for the smoke. He's asking for the smoke right here. Coming out of every rapper. Some battling raps, I want some swag. Cause I don't really just get the fact that I'm slim as a black and platinum status is whack if I'm not the baddest. Just like in the Kamikaze song, was it Lucky? I think it was. I can't remember. Anyways, doesn't matter. But talking about a plaque, who cares about a plaque? It doesn't matter as long as if I'm not the baddest. So he's got to be the baddest. And I know I went off topic trying to say make this the best workout song of all time, but it all plays in because, if I'm not the baddest at what I'm doing, which is motivation to work out, then what's the point of doing it? Yeah, so started off the reaction or the review basically because I read a Time magazine article saying it's the number one workout song of all time, so I wanted to go back to it, revisit it, check it out. And I get it. I understand it. Like all of the lyrics are about motivation. It's it's almost like a Lose Yourself type song. It's all about do what you do, take care of yourself. If you got a problem with me, bring it because I got the smoke and I'm ready for it. So yeah, I have to say I agree with Time Magazine. Another dope song from I would put this one in the Slim Shady category almost because he's kind of asking for a little smoke and he's talking big about himself. I know people like to do, oh, is it Marshall? Is it Slim? Is it Eminem? Fuck, it's all of them, but this is more Slim Shady than anything. But let me know what you think. Do you agree? Do you disagree? Do you think it's the best workout song of all time? Do you work out to it if you work out? Obviously, I don't work out that often. You could probably tell. But if I did work out, this would be on my playlist, top of it. So let me know what you think. I would say YouTube fam, what do you think? But I don't have a fam yet. So that means you need to subscribe, you need to like, and let's start a fam. Let's become a family. Let's do this together because there's a lot more artists out there and we can, share some bars. Deuces.